Your beauty shine from within. Let your situation be such that you can make a 20 naira outfit look like a 2,000 naira outfit. And that comes with your panache. It comes with your style. It comes with the way you present yourself. It comes with the way you express yourself. And that comes from inner beauty. Let your inner beauty shine through. Right? People won't be bothered as to how nicely you are dressed and how smart you look and what a smart car you drive, because they want to see what's inside you. Right? Beauty must always be skin deep. But don't let your husband tell you, I love you because of your inner beauty. Tell him, ask him, when did you see my adorable pancakes? Okay? So, next one. Consume what you need, not what advertisers tell you you want. That's the problem. Right? We always get taken away with all of this advertising, and we end up buying that which we don't need at all. Let me tell you something. When you walk into a supermarket, they've had industrial psychologists work out exactly where things need to be kept, how they need to be displayed, where they need to be displayed. Right? What smell should be emitted from you, from your thing? Right? You know, normally when you are going into the, when you're standing in line that you repay, that's where the sweets are kept. That's where the little things are kept. Oh, you're small, let me buy this one. They work like that. Right? They have what you call this thing, they have this, a nice word, loss leader. Is that the term for it? Right? Where they will sell something at a cheaper price. Right? To attract you into the shop. And once you got inside, they know that you're going to spend the rest of the money on far more expensive items because you're going to do that. And this is what is important. To get rid of the affluenza, you're going to make a conscious choice. Do I need this? Or can I do without it and there's no need for it at all? You know, most of these gadgets that you and I have, in terms of technology, 99% of them, we could do without. Let me give you an anecdote of this. I went to Pakistan and beat the absent-minded chappie that I am, right, in one village, and I meant to make wudu. I left my phone, right, on the bed and I walked out. Because I don't bother with phones, I reached Lahore, and we did a little bit of shopping and eating and whatever it is. And then finally, when I need to figure out how many dollars do I need to pay this guy, hey, where's my phone? And I realized it was 400 kilometers away. So anyway, I got home of them, and I told them, please send my phone. Now, they can't DHL a phone because they don't know whether you put a bomb on it. You know, it could be a remote bomb on it. So DHL said, sorry, we can't help you. So I had to wait for a guy to send my phone for me, drive down for 400 kilometers, come to Lahore, get somebody to fly from Lahore to Dubai, and then from Dubai, find a guy, come to Durban to bring my phone. Anyway, I wasn't bothered. It took me 1 month or 1.5 months before my phone returned. The only people who went crazy were the people who were trying to get hold of me. I had the best 1.5 months of my life in terms of my digital communications life. It was like having my... not having my second wife screaming into my ear all the time. Best 1.5 months of my life. Why? Don't need it. Don't need it. They embed themselves in your life. Technology and all of these brands embed themselves in your life until you become so dependent on them that you feel that you can't do without them. I know people who dream of the day when they can buy the latest Louis Vuitton bag. I'm not joking with you. I heard a lady, she was saying in front of me, if we increase the rent by 2,000 in this rental year, in 9 months, I'll have the money for the new Louis Vuitton bag. I didn't tell her that. What's wrong with you? I didn't tell her that. My look alone was enough. Anyway, right? Meet your children's needs. This is very important, because someone asked me this question, what's really important? Meet your children's needs, not the desires of little adults. Write that down in gold. Meet your children's needs, not the desires of little adults who are too big for their boots, who think that they're entitled to a cell phone at the age of 9 or 10. And there are some ignorant people who go out and give their children those phones at the age of 9 or 10. Meet your children's needs, not the desire of little adults. Let them throw a tantrum. So what? Throw a tantrum. Tough, you know. But all my friends have it, you know. So what? That's it. I told you, we are a very child-centered family nowadays. We are obsessed. Our lives revolve around them. And they created a sense of entitlement. A sense of entitlement. Let me give you another anecdote, how Affluenza works. And this is a real life story of one of the very wealthy and very, very philanthropic families in Durban. Right? They actually leased out a property of theirs for a school. So because it was convenient close to their house, they would send their children to the very school and the property that they owned. Okay? And every day the driver would come, you know, in the highest or whatever, put the kids inside and take it. It so happened that the driver didn't appear for 3 or 4 days because he was sick. So the grandfather, who owned one of these very fancy import model cars in those days, in the early 90s, took the grandchildren to school. He said, the driver is in jail, I take them to school. And he took them for the next 3 days. On the fourth day when the driver came back and they went back to the highest, the children came to the dada and said, dada, can you take us in the car again today? The dada said, okay. So when he got into the car, he asked him, why do you want me to take you? The driver declared, he said, no, Dada, since you've been taking us to school for the past 3 days, a lot of people became our friends. This was in a private Muslim school in Durban. The father heard them, left them at school. In the evening, he called his sons, whose children they were. And he said to them, he said, this is my experience that I had with my children. I know we own this property. I know that this building belongs to us. Take your children, it's my suggestion to you, it's your family, but you take the children out of your school and put them in your public school. Because I can see, what, you know, those are not the ones, they're afflicted by affluenza. Right? Anyway, that's all the story that I knew. About 2-3 weeks ago, when I confirmed the story at the Juma, the man whose daughter was also part of this came and told me, he said, no, there's another part of the story. He sent his child from a private school, they come from a very privileged family background. He sent his child from a private school to Juma Masjid in Durban, right, in Cathedral. It's a very poor area, it's a very poor school. Right? He sent her there. For the first 2 weeks, she was miserable because she wasn't accustomed to the public school type of system. But by the second week, she came home to her dad and she said, Daddy, you know what? Can I take 2 extra slices of sandwiches tomorrow? So he asked her, but why? And she was very happy on that day. So he says, you know, Daddy, today I saw a girl who didn't have school and didn't have a sandwich. And I shared with her my sandwich. And I asked her, how many days did she come to school without a lunch? And she said, no, she doesn't come to school for lunch because they can't afford to, you know, bring lunch to school. So her father told her, my dear, don't take 1 sandwich today only or tomorrow only. Take it from now till whenever you want for the school friend. He said it changed her outlook in life. An outlook in terms of who she was as a young child, simply by her being influenced positively by what she saw in terms of poverty. Now, come okay? Number 6, very quickly because of time. Educate your children. Educate your children. Don't brainwash them. Don't brainwash them. Now what is happening is that we don't expose our children to any other aspects of life. The only thing that they have experienced is comfort. The only thing that our children experience are luxuries. The only thing that our children experience are the fancy holidays and the fancy car. They don't know anything else besides that which is luxurious. Okay, it may be in accordance to your status of wealth or whatever it is, but expose them to the other realities of life. Expose them to what it means not to have it, how to do without it. Expose them to that and educate your children about the ploys of the advertisers and how fake these things are and how unreal they are and how unrealistic they are and how overpriced they are. You know, people in the clothing industry always tell me that they will never go to a retail store and buy an outfit. Simply because they say, we manufacture it. We know what's the manufacturing cost and how you guys are getting ripped off in retail. That's a clear example. Say, educate your children, don't brainwash them. Inform them about these realities. Talk to them about it. Show them the differences in all of these things so they become street savvy. They don't become just sheep. They're just following what the world of consumerism has to offer them. Don't brand them. Don't brand them. Don't make them aware and conscious of brands at a very early age. Don't create snob value in them. Very critical. So educate your children. Don't brainwash them. And in terms of mothers in particular, because they have to bear the brunt of the responsibility of the upbringing of the children, generally in Indian Muslim communities or whatever the situation may be. Right? For mothers as well, right? In terms of affluenza, enjoy your motherhood and celebrate your motherhood. And don't overcompensate for your children by giving them, and this is for fathers as well, don't overcompensate with your children by giving them material wealth and thinking that this will cover, right? And will be adequate for all the time that you didn't spend. No amount of money spent is equivalent to time spent. No amount of money in terms of children's upbringing is equivalent to time spent. Your children will be far more enriched if you spend time with them instead of spending money with them. Okay? Most importantly, right? Be sincere, right? And true to Allah, not true to yourself. Be true to Allah, not true to yourself. Today's modern society tells you, be true to yourself. Be who you are. Do what you want to do. Make your own choices. Because you're worth it. You deserve it. You know, and all of these adverts and so on. Be true to Allah, not true to yourself. Because if you're going to be true to yourself, you are being true to your ego. You are giving in to the desires of your ego and your nafs. And what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated in the hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated. He said, "Ta'isa abdu dinar wa dirham wa al-qatifa wa al-khamisa in u'tiya radiya wa in lam yu'ta lam yu." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Perish the slave of the dinar, abdu dirham." Abdul Dinar, the slave, right, of the dinar, the dirham, the qatifa, thick soft cloth, you know, the fancy materials, you know, your embroidered materials and the cashmeres and the linens and all of these things, right? Thick soft cloth, and khamisa, garments, all the fancy garments that you have and so on, and your haute couture, and you know, your fancy branded names and whatever it is there. Perish, you are the slave, the Prophet of Sultan, you are perished, you've been destroyed. And the Prophet said, what is the sign that you've been destroyed? For if he is given, he is pleased. When you have it, when people give it to you, right, then he makes you happy. Otherwise, he is dissatisfied. And that is what we call the need for greed. And that's a major, major, major issue. Okay, very quickly, let me tell you what the basic requirements are in terms of affluenza. What's the answer to affluenza? There's another term for it. It's called spiritual affluence. What's the cure for affluenza? Spiritual affluence. You and I attribute value to how much we are worth in terms of what is our bank balance. That's how we attribute and how wealthy we are. So the more amount of gold and money and silver and dollars you have in your bank account, and the bigger your property portfolio, and the fancier your home, and the fancier your car, you measure your wealth by virtue of these material things. But the Prophet ﷺ gave a yardstick for wealth measurement, true wealth measurement. He said, "Laysa al-ghina an kathrat al-ard, walakin al-ghina ghina al-qalb." Wealth is not defined by the amount of money you have. But true wealth is defined by the amount of contentment that you possess in your heart. How spiritually affluent are you? Not how materially affluent you are. If you have absolute contentment in your heart with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you, and you have no issues, and you're sleeping comfortably at night, not wishing and thinking and desiring how I wish I had this, and how I hope I have this, and how I can make more money. You are the wealthiest person. You may not have the most amount of money, but in terms of ghina al-qalb, in terms of the prophetic definition of what true wealth is, the Prophet of Allah is saying, you're the richest person on earth. لَيْسَ الْغِنَا عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الْعَرْضِ وَلَكِنَّ الْغِنَا غِنَا الْقَلْبِ. One. Now, you want to know what is the basic requirement, right? In terms of having all your needs fulfilled, in terms of wealth, in terms of material value, the Holy Prophet said, "Man asbaha minkum aminan fi sirri, mu'afan fi jasadi, indahu quta yawmi, fakannama khiyazat ad-dunya." The Prophet said, "Whosoever wakes up in the morning in a condition that he is secure in his dwelling." He's got a house. He's got a roof on top of his head. Right? Mu'afan fi jasadi. And he's healthy. Indahu quta yawmi. And he has with him enough provisions for the day. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَكَأَنَّمَا خِيَزَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا. It is as if the treasures of the world have been amassed for him. In terms of material value, if you are in a secure dwelling, and if you are good in terms of health, And if you are in a condition when you have enough food just for the day, the Prophet of Allah said, you have